close to 1,000 energy sector stakeholders, academicians, government, civil society, among others, have today converged in Kampala for the Renewable Energy Conference. During the conference, they shared experience and lessons, including strategies which will help in promoting renewable energy for sustainable development. The Prime Minister, Robin Anabanja, gave assurance that the government is to heavily invest in the industrialization strategy so that citizens can easily access clean energy. This was in her speech, which was delivered by the State Minister for Winyoro Affairs, Jennifer Namiangu.
Our strategy, therefore, must be to ensure that our population migrates to cleaner energy in order to address the challenges of deforestation and indoor pollution, among others.
According to the State Minister of Energy, Okasai Sindronias Opolod, provision of clean and affordable energy is a catalyst for sustainable development in the country. With a growth in the country's electricity generation, he called for more consumption by both the industries and the households, arguing that this will greatly help reduce the end-user tariffs.
And I would want to tell the population, if there are few people connected, we are generating power. We are generating those 1,300 megawatts. If it is not used and there are only few people who are using it, you actually have to share the cost of production among the few who are using electricity. That's why we're encouraging the population to use electricity. It will contribute to reducing the tariffs. And most of the heaviest consumers of electricity are industries. And if we can put more electricity into productive uses, into the industries, we household users who contribute very little and consume little, we shall manage to reduce the tariffs. So long as we are generating the electricity and it is not being used, the cost will be shared among the few who are using it.
The Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development, Irene Batebe, noted that Norway has put in place a fund worth $1 billion for the companies investing in clean energy in Africa. She encouraged those in this business to seek the funds.
We have a lot that we are doing with GIZ and KfW, that's from the German corporation. They support us in grid expansion. They support us in mini grids, you know, for far to reach areas. They support us in areas of energy efficiency, but also skilling of Ugandans. So it's a lot that we do with our development partners.
The conference went hand in hand with an expo where several renewable energy products were exhibited, including the electric vehicles. Relatedly, environmental activists have held a news conference today where they encouraged farmers to embrace the new model of growing trees, dubbed the farmer-managed natural regeneration system. This type of growing trees is based on the regeneration of native trees and shrubs from mature root systems of previously cut down trees. Story by Juliet Namoya for the news.